Hugo is a man of his time. He doesn't need to get up from his couch to adjust the temperature of his apartment. He doesn't need to know when to water his plant. He doesn't need to look for his keys to go home. He is a well-connected man of the world. His is the life of a mobile citizen. The hyper-connected society in which we live isn't the idyllic world in advertisements portrayed by mobile phone companies. Corporations, governments, individuals, they all develop vulnerabilities within their security at a time while cybercrime proliferates and asymmetric warfare is common. Hackers are rarely identified and governments are powerless to stop attacks within their borders. Cybercrime goes unpunished. The widespread use of the Internet of Things opens the back door to hackers. By 2020, their numbers will rise to 50 billion, and they exist in our everyday lives, in our cars, our homes, our public transport, our hospitals. However, their level of security is weak, if non-existent. This simple observation shows how the fundamental aspects of our daily lives are jeopardized. Jay Radcliffe demonstrated this idea at a conference that it is possible to hack into a connected insulin pump by injecting an overdose causing the death of its user. Fearing a cyber attack, former U.S. Vice President Dick Cheney found it more prudent to disconnect the communication capabilities of his pacemaker during his term. As we move toward the widespread use of the Internet of Things, attacks within industrial infrastructure are already a reality. Is it delusional to imagine that our water and energy supplies could be threatened? Nothing could be more wrong. During the harsh Ukrainian winter of 2015, hackers broke into the computer system of the power grid. Little by little, they managed to seize all of the data and all of the controls. On the evening of December 23, a blackout occurred. 225,000 Ukrainians were deprived of light and heating. This operation represented one of the largest industrial cyber attacks ever recorded. Even more spectacular, in June 2017, at the headquarters of Maersk, panic erupted through the corridors. The computer network collapsed. The screens turned black, one after the other. At the same time in New York, hundreds of trucks were immobilized at Port Elizabeth. The system could no longer scan their merchandise or open electronic doors. The food inside the containers had rotted. The same situation was experienced in Los Angeles, Spain, the Netherlands, and India. This was the most monumental crisis in the history of maritime IT. 17 ports throughout the world became paralyzed. Such were the devastating effects of the NotPetya virus. Experts agree on one point. Such an attack is bound to reoccur and on a much greater scale. The operating system of hackers, as varied as they are, don't only rely on technological weaknesses. The initial invasion of cybersecurity is usually a human or organizational cause. In the case of the Ukrainian power grids, hackers have orchestrated an operation consisting of social engineering and field recon during the 6 months preceding the attack. The worm was in the apple from the point when the employee had the naivete of opening an email infected by a malware. It turns out that this employee had privileged accesses to the industrial network, and by taking control of his station, hackers managed to get into the network to dissect its workings. The attack was prepared over several weeks to cause maximum damage, ultimately interrupting the energy supply over several hours. The proliferation of cyber attacks is undermining the critical digital trust. If the next earthquake cripples vital infrastructures, public opinion will not hold hackers accountable, but rather companies, suppliers, subcontractors who have not been able to protect them by anticipating such risks.